The Kampala City Mortuary in Mulago has said it is stuck with three burnt feet of victims who died in last Tuesday's fuel tanker blast in Wakiso District. This was revealed by police pathologist and director of health services, AIGP Dr. Moses Biaranga, yesterday Sunday, as the remains of some of the victims of the tragic fire were handed over to their respective families. Among the 11 bodies that were handed over yesterday were those of the victims who were burnt beyond recognition and required DNA testing to establish their kin, as well as some of those who succumbed to injuries in the hospital. Other families had already received the remains of their loved ones, who were easily recognizable without having to undergo DNA testing. This included some who died on the spot. As of yesterday, the death toll stood at 24, having gradually risen from 11 who were reported to have died on the spot on the fateful day. ICT and National Guidance State Minister Godfrey Kabianga, present at the somber handover event, conveyed condolences to the bereaved families.
It was so devastating accident, and it took a lot, as you have heard from police, 24 productive Ugandans. The most devastating thing now, which is a new development, is the 3 feet, a set of 3 feet of juveniles. Those might have been kids, as the doctor has said, which is very, very devastating, because even the bodies are not seen.
Following the tragic incident, President Yoweri Museveni gave each family of the deceased 5 million shillings to support burial arrangements. He also gave the injured 1 million shillings each to assist in the medical bills and recovery. Works on the long-awaited 73-kilometer Kapchorwa Swam Road project has been completed and now awaits official commissioning. Uganda National Roads Authority UNRA Executive Director Allen Kajina has revealed. Kajina said the Kapchorwa Swam, Kitale and Eldoret Bypass Roads project is a multinational operation that provides an important link between Uganda and Kenya by connecting at the border post of Swam. She said the Ugandan side of the project road is Kapchorwa Swam and the Kenya side of the project road is Swam, Kitale and Eldoret Bypass. Kajina further revealed that the project road supports the regional integration objective of the member countries of the East African Community EAC and the Great Lakes region, especially Uganda and Kenya, by connecting to Swam and further linking the Democratic Republic of Congo DRC and South Sudan. The caretaker of Buganda, Charles Peter Maiga, has urged coffee-growing areas of the country not to relent in their enthusiasm for growing the crop, saying the venture is very productive and is a good way to get out of poverty. He also said the Kingdom of Buganda is against scrapping the Uganda Coffee Development Authority, UCDA, since it superintends coffee production, upon which nearly 2 million Ugandan households depend. He was on Saturday weighing in on the controversy that has recently enveloped the crop, causing unease in Buganda where the crop is widely grown. On Thursday, Parliament voted to advance the National Coffee Amendment Bill 2024, which proposes the dissolution of the Uganda Coffee Development Authority, UCDA, after 32 years of operation. During a two-day clash of ideas, MPs from coffee-growing regions faced off against their colleagues from areas where the cash crop is not cultivated.
Those who are pushing for the authority, shall we have the authority for cassava, authority for banana, authority for beans, authority for maize? They created a department in the Ministry of Agriculture. And that department is doing very well and maintaining international issues of
peace. I want to put the minister. If the minister of Agriculture is doing well, let him stand here and tell us one crop which they have done so well to give us a basis of confidence that they are up to anything.
In a rare division vote, 159 legislators supported sending the bill to the Committee of the Whole House for close-by-close consideration, while 77 legislators, primarily from the opposition, voted against it.